Welcome, those of you who are here visiting for Open House, and welcome, of course, everybody else. We're really excited to welcome tonight Momoyo Kajima to present the work that she and her partner, Yoshiharu Tsukamoto, are engaged with under the famous name now of Atelier Bow Wow. We have the great pleasure to have Momoyo teaching at GSAPP this semester. I'm really looking forward to involve her more in the future. I have secret plans, but after the lecture. I think it's fair to say that Atelier Bow Wow have inspired, led, and captured much of their generation's architectural ethos, its mode of being, of engaging discourse and practice, and its commitment to understanding and reimagining the world, whether cities, the environment, the social, the problem of scale, or more recently, the ecology of the rural through architecture and design. Just think of what comes to mind, to your mind, in terms of this particular generation of architects' work, reinventing the everyday, the return of typology, the interest in scale, mostly small, the re-engagement with the question of the city, with an architecture that is inseparable from both the idea of city and from the idea of the ordinary, as Enrique Walker would call it, the lived-in city, the city of constructed situations, of social encounters, and of hybridized objects, programs, and typologies that turn architectural concepts into enchantment, from the transforming of bicycles into mobile furniture to the strategic reconceptualization of a leftover roofscape into a lyrical playground and park. Bow Wow's is certainly an engaged form of practice, expanding architectural thinking to reread everything while also devouring everything else with great precision and delicacy, but also with a voracious appetite and curiosity to re-enter architecture. This constant feedback loop between discourse and practice and between books and buildings is not unique, of course, but in the hands and minds of Momoyo and Yoshi, it becomes unbelievably rich in inventiveness while also cementing an undeniable continuity in their work and as a way to constitute a body of work. With every new building is a new book, with every new book, a new set of ideas, and with every new set of ideas, a new project, at once completely surprising, influential, and yet also undeniably consistent. Alongside their seminal projects, too many to name, furniture, houses, installations, buildings, parks, speculative projects, etc., are also the seminal books. In 2001, their pet architecture registered the potential of leftover space in Tokyo, and Made in Tokyo rendered visible the possibilities of already existing hybrid conditions and programs to inform architecture. Both research projects turned publications into the condition of Tokyo, enabled them to theorize and then propose the design of what they termed micro-public spaces. In 2006, they published Post-Bubble City, and in 2007, they published Graphic Anatomy Volume 1, knowing there was another volume to come, an incredible in-depth foray into construction documents and specifications turned poetics, as if the zooming into the layered detailing of their work opened up an entirely new world, a new understanding of their practice, and as a result of not God, but the beauties and pleasures and meanings of the ordinary. In 2010, they outlined their embrace of behaviorology in architecture as a manifesto for rendering inseparable the social from the physical, where one continuously informs and transforms the other. Much of that thinking, research, and writing transpires through their work, with, as hinge, of course, the unique forms of representations they have developed, drawings and models, and which have become signature of the office's practice, as well as a source of infatuation for students around the world. Just look at students' drawings today. The sectional bird's eye, the axo, the black and white line drawing, the complex yet cute urban condition, or the whimsical architectural situation. Indeed, many of these can be traced directly to Bow Wow's representational practices, which are clearly bringing much design intelligence to the dense urban conditions we increasingly find ourselves in across the planet, and it seems like in tonight. More recently, they have turned their attention to the rural condition in Japan through their involvement in Odaka and its rebuilding, with architecture playing a critical role in reassembling a community and enabling it to imagine a different future for itself. A project that projects the future but also builds on the richness of the natural resources and cultural resources, as well as on the history of its context. This is the topic of the studio Momoyo is teaching this semester here at the school. It is entitled Redesigning the Actor Network in Fukushima and brings all her architectural design thinking to the ecology of rural livelihood in Japan. I won't say any more because I suspect this will be one of the principal topics of tonight's lecture. And so tonight you are in fact having a glimpse both of Bow Wow and Momoyo's always challenging thinking and engaged process, but also of her kind of teaching pedagogy, to a pedagogy and a practice that are really committed and successfully expanding architecture's territory, its contributions, its possibilities, and of course its pleasures. So please join me in welcoming Momoyo.
Yes, thank you very much for having me to have a really so great opportunity to present our project. And also teaching in Columbia University, it's also a very great experience. And I was also surprised how small table for each student. But it's an urban context, it makes the students very unite in among the studio. I think that is also the, I taught several different, the world, different school, but also the this kind of density makes the students more kind of nice. Yeah, I realize. So. But I very so expected what my students proposed to the final review. So. Okay, today I would like to introduce our recent method. The title will be Creating Better Accessibility to the Local Resources. Why we reach this kind of idea? So one photograph it shows is just after the 2011 earthquake in Japan. So the many fishermen's village along the coast were damaged by tsunami. And this photograph was taken by in around 3 months later after the disaster. And I was visiting with my students to have a kind of interview to the local fishermen to what they want to have in the future for the recovery. And at the moment, we are looking for some new residence area. And but also during the this walk, we saw a very beautiful forest in the back of the village. And we thought how we can use this forest industry, because the forest was planted almost 50, 60 years ago by the fisherman's family, because the land, originally land used as the vegetation, but after so the accessibility is much easier to buy the car or a bus or another accessibility, it makes them to more focusing on the fishery. So in that sense, so they started to utilize other purpose for their vegetation garden or field to plant the future resources for the building materials. And but unfortunately, so it was not maintained by them. So because of the, I think the fishery is much easier to get more income. So that's why so they a little bit forgot the maintain of the forest. So I think this is of course the topic of the disaster Tohoku area issue. But this. My kind of the problem of the forest, unused forest, is now the, in Japan is a very, very strong intention to recover or refound the as a future material or a construction of the society itself. And for this recovery project, we proposed one project. It's called the Core House. It was used as a kind of local timber for the material, and also using for the local that a skill from the carpentry. And also that this, we expect that for the recovery after the disaster, the whole house were supported by this, or kind of the encouragement of the local industry or local carpentry or local resources to also be recovered as the same network. But unfortunately, the last, I think, 20 or 30 years in Japan, so Japanese forest industry were very, very damaged by the North American imported timber, for example. And also the we a little bit forgotten the management of this kind of forest. And also that this kind of context make them to very weak point of the industry. So in that sense, if we want to utilize as a recovery technique, so our method in a process supporting for the recovery of the disaster area, so in fact, it's really difficult to utilize. And in this core house, we propose also the fishermen wanted to have a mini, at first, all the, their incomes to try to bring them their own business, so they don't utilize for the many money to the house at first, I heard. So that's why so we propose a minimum house at first they built, where they will build, and then next income coming, so they will add, and finally, so they will be reach the larger scale house. And we propose making by model house as office of the temple in the local area. It was also donation by the some several company or several association. And we built, and still this building was used as the communal center. And also we propose another area, Tsukahara area, is a same area of what we are working on the studio, Columbia University studio, the Odaka area. And the, in this case, I propose at first the private single house as a communal, as the core house. But finally, so at first we reached the making the this system to be the communal house. That this is the opening days of the communal house with the inhabitants or village. And but unfortunately, in now the after the disaster, so 6 years passed now. But in fact, the recovery process is very, very difficult, not so easy to manage, because national government decided to make a kind of recovery for just 5 years. And this rural area has already industry, building industry were also very going to the very weak because of the decreasing of the population and aged society itself. So it gave them to more weaker of the industry. So that's why, so the now the recovery process, the many, for example, housemaker or different industry coming from the outside of the area to support or to also the kind of new market, so for them to create a new market. So in fact, the if we, for example, lift visual images, it's a 1960s, all houses were made by traditional carpentry and every resources coming from the mountain or area. But today, 2016, so we saw the very, very different recovery from the original, so former existing condition. It's also very like a new residence area, the same as Tokyo, for example. So the but we are still struggling. So how it called? Of course, it's recovered, some sense. But maybe we miss something, so instead of, for example, landscape or connection of the nature or culture, etc. And now that I'm trying to give you some examples, not only in Japan, so some other things. The last 2 or 3 years that we did abroad. First one is in a Belgium project. In this project, it's very resources is kind of the water itself. In Belgium has many channels, so in the city, and Bruges has also the beautiful so canal town. And for example, 1976, at the moment, the people swam in the channel, so in the summertime. So that's why so you see the very, very, so kind of the public space in the channel. So. But unfortunately, because of the pollution of the water, the city were started to prohibited the to the swimming so in the channels, and people forgotten so the where is the channel possibility or what is the openness of the channel, etc. And then, but pollution are going to better and better. Pollution is getting, what do you call it? So pollution is, water is much more so cleaner than the 1976. And now the water is very so good enough to clean so for swimming. So the 2014, this is the year the city started to decide to the if a good water quality, so people can start to swim. And this is a kind of like news, weather news, or well, water news for city. So today you can swim, or today is a little bit difficult, etc. So they made a kind of signal so in a channel so too. And then we heard this kind of story. So the city wanted to have open the water of the channel. So our proposal is making kind of platform for this openness. But water itself are used as a kind of tourism so for of boating. And and so we propose for the structure with the NATO or pontoon, and also the in the channel, so there are no roof, so that's why so we propose some very so light steel structure roof, and this is the view of the finalization. The pontoon were crossing the bridge, under the bridge. And one side having the roof, and the roof under the roof, so that there is a sloping by the wheel access and also the stairs. And the wood deck was utilized as kind of second-hand wood. It's very so nicely so weathering, and people can enjoy in the city so the water like a beach. So today, for example, red flag, it's people cannot enter the water, but the people can enjoy the sun, so for example. And this is the opening day, so it's still a very cold day, but they jump in the water. So very in the May, it's very cold, I think. Yeah, and but this is also the kind of first news for the how opening happens in the channel. And another project I explained about in the Darmstadt in Germany, that it was happened on the same year, 2014. That theme is in Darmstadt there are very so heavy, very beautiful the architecture, historical the heritage. It's called the Matilda Hill project. And they have a very beautiful kind of artist residence and museum and atelier house, etc. And they are still very beautiful kept. And they want to have a kind of have a new World Heritage submission as a 100th anniversary, 100 years anniversary. So that this kind of event or project are kind of related to the, this promotion of the city itself. And the next to this residential area, my middle, so you will see, so middle there is some forest. This forest was not used as in exhibition space. So the idea was, let's make a public space in the forest to build by a kind of DIY buildings designed by the architect and artist. And it was happened in a summer school, so it's in 6 weeks in August and maybe June and August. July and August, and there's several so architects and artists were invited to the support as a tutor, and he is the construction level. The Alex was so the kind of the leader of the architect, but he worked for as a carpentry, and all students were camping in the site. And at first, they made own cottages, and also they made a workshop by themselves. And all building was done by the students. So it's really rough and tough, wild project, I imagine. But it's also very interesting. So many, many female students from the all over the world, they're coming, and they are very enjoyed to work hard. So that is very impressive for me, too. And also that they made a nice shower booth. And also they made a kitchen, so still going, so but they have a kitchen, and every meal from the breakfast, lunch, and dinner is provided by their own. So. And once, so I was asked by making some event, but I had at first, I thought that I might have a lecture. But not. In fact, I was asked by cooking Japanese food. So that I made a pork miso soup, maybe 150 people pork miso soup. And it's one story, strange story. So that I asked the German students to buy the pork meat. Né? And I expect the small piece of the meat, but they bought the so big pork meat and bring me to the kids. Wow! how long it takes to cutting slice pizza? I took almost 3 hours for cutting small pieces. So. But anyway, so it's very tasty. It was tasty. Okay, so then I spent maybe so 1-2 weeks there, and so I had also very good chance to opportunity to build out the main structure by the carpentry, but the substructure all made by the students. And also the interesting, the making the process, they also make also the beautiful graphics in the some signage or sometimes t-shirts or team t-shirts or so in the site, on the site. So it's also very beautiful. And also the one of the construction lab interior designers, so she made, she designed a beautiful bending chair. Collaborate with the furniture factory. So that was made by also the collaboration with the student and company and the designer. So we, after the making the chair, so we can use also as a lecture. So it's also very interesting. So still ongoing, so, but the people can enjoy the summer and also discussing. So it's very one-to-one scale activities that happen on the site. And this is our project. It's very simple. So we call like a temple. So it's a simple main structure. The covering is the polycarbonate weaving board. And then it could be open to the, it's a kind of the balance of the top, there are some stone, so that it could be turned open with gravity. And if it's open, so it's like a stage on the outside. So some people can play the music, and that's around the building, so people can enjoy the hearing the sounds. And sometimes they have some big event for Yoshi is here anyway. so in the kind of visual, so public viewing, etc. And also night, they have some small so fire, a camping fire. So it's also very, we had a fun time so at the night. And also this is another project. So we back to the Japan. So this project is the newest project though. So yesterday was opening day. So that's why I want to show you. So it's a very so tiny, not huge building, but it's very interesting framework of the kind of the communal space. Mori means forest, and machia is a townhouse. So it's called kind of the townhouse for forest. Why so forest? Because machia is a kind of typology of the we are very impressed recently, last 10 years. This is a special typology in Japan. So mostly the urban context, the narrow width and the long depth. And then so always the facade were maximizing of the using of the kind of quality of the life. And also that sometimes they have a shop or a factory in the house. So that means they are living and also they're working together in the house. So the very so narrow and small building, but it has a many, many different connection. And also the interesting was along the street, the these typology were repeated each along the one by one. So that means each face of the townhouse are kind of so connected to the street, and the people can enjoy the differentiation of the each buildings as a facade. And we had studied about the machia in Kanazawa at first, and after, so we are also the very impressed at the possibility of the design of the today's machia. So the last traditional one was kind of, it was founded almost 1,000 years ago. So it's very long history, so historical so building. But now in Tokyo, so we have also similar structure of the landform, and also the density of the city itself is makes much higher and higher. So that means now that we have a lot of the commission coming from the individual private owner who wants to have a individual house for them. And in that sense, sometimes a house have a face to the very narrow width and the long depth. And then so we propose to thinking about how relate the existing typology with in this context, and also the how what we can do in the different from the proposed to the new typology. So today I don't show the inside, but mainly so facade could be also the kind of the nice face, but also the interior space we try to make a more kind of horizontal and vertical connection in between the floor and floor with steps, etc. And back to the forest at Machia. Why we started to call this forest? Because the client is a shrine, so old shrine, very close from the site. This is a very tensile shrine, and they have a very beautiful the forest around the shrine. So because as a traditionally, so shrine cultivated the future resources of the forest in the land. For example, Ise or Izumo, many shrine has a very big forest or mountain. So the forest and the shrine is very related to the kind of network of the culture. And that is a history. And this forest, for example, 1936, the area was still kept as a forest. But after the war, already so this area was started to urbanize or just settled by the some so merchant or kind of townhouse for the residents and the shopping area. And but 1963, the shrine needs to survive to because of the changing the law, and also the changing of the kind of land use. So that's why so they need to survive to sell their own forest to the area or some people who want to buy, and then so they get some income so from the selling money, and then to they try to keep the land itself and as the shrine, and and then today the building stands on the here, but originally it was a forest, so today it's here. So that means. But still shrine always thinking about the how it relates to the neighbors, the which kind of history they have so before. So the project names try to remind the people to this kind of the historical so transformation of the shrine. Because today the shrine is, how can I say, a little bit sometimes difficult to keep in the management. So because, for example, in Europe sometimes the church management is very difficult to, because everybody a little bit forgotten the kind of the religious things or this kind of new media or new things happen. So. Instead of these kind of things. But I think a Japanese shrine still try to keep some sort of the role of the unite of the among the community. So that, and also that this shrine is try to do this. So that's why so they want to have some new space for people to could be utilized as more easy by them. And recently, for example, some of the young owner or young, how do you call it, kind of so young shrines or owners tried to activate the relationship between the shrine and the people. So, for example, this is they opened the market in the shrine, the forest, for example. And already, so they started to kind of the new network in a local community. So this project, we started to the kind of the making dialogue to or engagement of the people to how through the project, how the shrine and the local people can engage in the building. So, for example, the purpose of the building or usage of the building, we are discussing several times as a workshop. And finally, so we reach, for example, the basement, it will be happen in the kind of stock for the food in a disaster, for the disaster moment. So, for example, earthquake, if it happens, so the people can come and take some food from the basement, or they can cook each other or support each other or exchange information, etc. So this could be also the kind of private, common kind of recovery center. And also the first floor, they will have a kitchen. On the secondary floor, so they will have some small classroom space or gathering space for town. So, and then, so this is the section. Well, we don't show the basement, but there is a basement. And this stair coming up and the secondary floor. And top, there is some storage space, but it could be used as some hall or library space. And the site is not rectangle, so it's more kind of cut it one side, so the very interesting form. So we utilize as much as possible with the stairs. And this is some dumbwaiter, so the stair coming up and using the following the wall of the outside. And also, we try to import it to some material, as a material point of view. So this kind of structure normally easy to make by steel in Japan. But in this case, we try to remind the people of the how related the forest. And the forest gives a sense of the timber structure. So that means, and also the timber structure, this kind of scale. So now we got some new rule of the making or fire protection issue. So it's a little bit more kind of possibility to design by timber structure. So that's why so we try to propose a simple structure, easy way, but made by the whole timber structure, timber. And this is the final, yesterday. And then so they have an opening party, and this is a building. So following the maximum height on the urban court, and this is entry. And so entry was painted the sliding door with the slit, and then so it could be open totally. And they have some mark. And also, this is the costume of the shrine people. So they make some nice meal. And then this stair going up. And the stair has a window. And in front of the window, there are some small benches. Yoshi, ne? Right. And this is the second floor. So window is very simple, so just open to the width. And back, so there are some symbolical color, reminds also the kind of shrine. And this panel could be closed to be wall. And here there is some void space. And in here, so this is a ceremony of the opening of the building. It's very Japanese. And this is the third floor. So the ceiling is follows the maximum height, but it's a more organic way and covers the many timber materials. And also yesterday was happening the lecture for the history. So many people watched the process of the building. And some of the door were taken from the shrine, kind of secondhand. So we found a very nice piece of the lamp or old door utilized for the new building. Okay, and now I showed another project in, it's called the 1K project. The area is called Katori area, so very close, 1 hour far from Tokyo, but it's not so accessible, but just by the highway, by car, but it's very close from the Narita airport. And the area has many hill and valley, so the valley part was utilized as a beautiful rice part. So this is a very beautiful landscape, it looks like. But unfortunately, these forests were also the abundant so looking. So originally, forests have a more transparency of the between the tree and tree. So, but now they have many bush on a covering so on the soil. So that's why, so it's not so beautiful looking. So unfortunately. And we worked for this area so with the one NGO who ran the elderly house and also the daycare center before this project. And they want to have a kind of change the welfare service because in Japanese case, and the welfare service are very, very limited budget, and also the always it's run by the subsidized of the government. So, and also very institutional framework. They cannot do the not so much many exceptions, so, unfortunately. But this NGO tried to make a more kind of encourage this kind of things so because age society and we need more people to come to join this field, younger generation. And also it's also very interesting chance to learning from the elderly people or learning from the disabled people to share the life or to share the society frames in a community. Or as one community. So this is also the very important role they felt for so activities. And so that's why so they tried to ask us to make some new building frame so for the activate this welfare service. For example, this building it's called the Loving Pork Laboratory. So the ground floor, they have a kind of factory, sausage and ham and shabu-shabu meat processing. So we can see from the window. And but this place were this place are also the good working place for the disabled people and normal people working together. So because of the now that it's very difficult to find out the for the disabled people to get the good enough new income. So that's why so they don't want to sell some production as a label with making disabled people too, etc. So just they want to sell the very tasty, delicious pork meat. And then so the income coming as a quality. And then so this income to provide many opportunity to work for the everybody. So that is their idea. Because of the one of the leader of the NGO, he ran the pork meat farm. So that's why, so of course they had a pride and also that they are very love to sell the good way. So the that is also my kind of double parallels or purpose of this project. And also that they try to have a kind of restaurant with the shabu-shabu meat and also sausage. And also they have also office on, so. And some open space. Will be used for the everything, so or more communal space. And building has many opportunity to give the people who has a kind of mental problem or some so disabled things. And for example, he has some problem, but he can clean and he can work as same as a normal way. So this NGO tried to give them the maximum opportunity to to have own work. And also, for example, he is also some sort of problem, but also that he can work together, and also he can support to the service of the restaurant. And also he, unfortunately, as a building, so this door is very big, so it's a little bit heavy for sliding, but he can help always to with smiling so to the guest. So, but this is a good combination, so. And this is the issue so for 1K. After this Loving Pork Laboratory project, they started to imagine the another possibility because behind of the Loving Pork Laboratory, so there are many forests. It was also abandoned. It was also very dark and not so used. So that every day, so owner or leader of the NGO, so they, he's very young, so around now the 35 years old, and he found so how we can manage this forest. And then he started to maintain the forest as a neighbors. But this is not belong to them, just the neighbors, the forest, but they started to maintain the kind of the some emotion or some idea. And then, but after, so the many neighbors, the farmers asked to them to the, also maintain their own, another forest. And then this kind of relational so things reminds him to make a create the another job space for the everybody to take care of the forest, to making firewood, or some another furniture that these kinds of activities will be happen in some workshop. So, and also workshop could be have also the daycare center because now the Japanese daycare center is mostly so there is no program so just sitting and eating and chatting so. Or sometimes playing the card or etc. So it's some people have a very so boring so to visit there. But some, for example, old gentlemen, they have a very happy to work with carpentry, small carpentry or log or these kind of things. But it's maybe also very interesting for them to come to the as daycare center program. So that this is the building so in the model. So there are some. Main workshop is happened here, and also there is some small furniture workshop, and also here is a kind of a sweet potato cake cooking place. But this is also another sub production because this area also very famous on the making the sweet potato, so good, very good one. So that's why so the NGO leaders started to, and also he loves the sweet potato, that's why so. So he thought, it might be okay so to make a so, restaurant. So. And also this is a fire log, a drying area. And also this is another maintenance part of the field for the forest, for example. Very simple building, so, but all element or resources coming from the closer local forest. We asked to the many so collaborator. But later I will show. So, for example, how this kind of job could be happen. So, for example, firewood chopping is normally so it's very difficult. Yeah? We need some so power, yeah? But. With this kind of dumping so machine, so it's more easy and safety to push the button and just to collaborate with two people. So it's more kind of communal or communicational. So the works it could be. So the this energy or the thought that it might be bring this kind of machine. If they bring this machine to this work processing, so. It could be also kind of the break the barrier of the working condition. So in the whole in a whole, so young and old, or female or male, etc. So the, it's, they can give more opportunity to the brighter, wide range of those people. And then so that this, and always in their kind of the management of the welfare service for disabled people working place, so they are always just making kind of manual so for them. So, and later I will show, but this is a kind of a workshop, so how, for example, forest leaking and also the slicing or chopping, these all process were into the divide into the separate small the works for everybody. And for example, this work could be possible for everybody. This work should be more technically or something like, so we can see the how work could be shared to the everybody. And then, so this is manual, that's only all in Japanese, unfortunately. But for example, we make some manual, for example, photograph and how to utilize and how each order happens or something like so. And also that doing this working, so we found many resources were also that didn't take care for the local people. For example, he is a forest industry so a manager. he cut many trees, but mostly tree timber material are not used for the nothing. So it's really so just left. So the we found so this kind of resources, and also that we found many meal factory existing in the area, because that means maybe so 40, 30 years ago or 20 years ago, the area was more so activated as a forest industry, so small business, so more individual business. So that's why so this project could be also related to this kind of forest industry management, and also the, this local the wood mill factory to give them the, some opportunity to job. And this is ACTA network on this project. But this 1K project, and this is a Loving Pork Factory project, and how related each. And also the this factory could be given the, some exchangeable program from urban and rural. And also the this 1K project also related to the local meal factory or farmers or forest manager, so on. so that means the, if we make a building, but we can represent of the how network were existing and how what is the opportunity to create or recreate or redesign of the network as a building. So this is still ongoing, so not fixed the final detail, but we try to utilize as a piece of the wood. And we observe the size of the wood, or thinking of the kind of so joinery or system, etc. So to fit to the condition for each. So this is my final project, what we will see. Now we are back into the Tohoku area. So this project after the 2011, so firstly, so just after the three days after the disaster, we started to discuss how we can create a platform for the recovery as a group of the architects. Now it's called the Arcade Project, and the Arcade has almost 300 architects submit of this platform. And then we collaborated, started to the exchange the idea or et cetera. And then this is one of the projects of the Arcade produce to create a kind of network project among the 15 different architects group. And I was a part of this, this called Oshika Peninsula. It has almost 30 different small and big fisherman villages. For example, here is maybe habitants around 2,000 or 3,000, or before maybe so 10,000, but now they're around 2,000 or 3,000. But for example, smallest one is just, I think, 30 people, something like. So very different size of the fisherman's village. And I worked for these three villages, Momonora and Tsukinora and Samuraihama. And for example, Yoshiharu, my partner, working for this different side of the villages. But today I showed one of these, Momonora. And in the arcade program, so we had many research at first, like interview to the each habitant from the fishermen's villages. And we asked them to the, what they want in the future and how recovery they wish to be. So, and after the, this kind of interview or enquete, so the, we started to understand how fisherman village culture is very, very rich it was. And still, so fishermen has many, many skill. For example, they can boating or shipping, and also that they can catch a fish, and they can read the weather, and sometimes they can have a management of the cooking, and also they can do manage all the forest too. Or I think the fisherman is a very, very talented person, so who can have a lot of knowledge of the life. And then so I was architects are very, very, so mostly our group are very impressed by them, so because they are strong, fishermen very strong and very individually, and some sympathy we felt as architects too. And then so but this is a kind of several, so we had several meetings in a community, and for example, this is a house. It was renovated after the tsunami, so he's a leader, local leader. He is now the 88 years old. At that moment, maybe 5 years ago, so it was a little bit younger. But many of them, they are aged, and also, but they are very strong. They are very still strong. And for example, this is my students, and I'm somewhere. I don't know, somewhere I am. But we are discussing once a month to what will be happen. And maybe so first or secondary meeting, that they started to say about the lack of the next generation for the fishermen. And this point, everybody started to think about how we can bring the newcomer for the fishermen to the area. So because of the average of the age of a fisherman, this area around 65 at the moment. So they are retired, I think, mid of 70s. So maybe in 10 years, mostly fishermen will be gone or will be die. So that's why, so if they have a lot of the traditional technology or kind of innovative new technology, but they couldn't pass to the next generation. So that is worried about from them. So so that's why, so we started to think about making fisherman's school. Not as a building at first, more the program, so with among the community as an event. And this was happened at first 2013 August. The program was run for 3 days program. For example, first day we walk in a community area, my disaster area, so there is very empty. But he tried to explain what happened in a disaster, and before the disaster, what happened, what was it, for example. And also the fisherman could be teacher in a school, but it is almost the first time, because fisherman encourage, or pedagogy means, so just they say so to younger, so look me, just nothing to say, so something like, so always observation or looking is one of the method of the teaching or learning, so each other. So that means that almost the first things to how to teach or how to learn, or so among the students and the fishermen too. And also we had a practice for the fishing, and also the enjoyable seafood, for example, with the cooking technique. And also during making the fisherman school, so we made a textbook. Now the first is just 10 pages, but after 5 years, and now we had almost 50 or 60 pages, so collecting the many different type of the fishing. So so now I have many knowledge. I don't know how to utilize, but so I have a lot of the things in my head. So so this kind of seasonal issue is also very important. For example, this fish coming up to the ocean in this moment, and everybody knows at this time is, for example, a crab is very famous, or this time the flatfish, or this time the seaweed is coming. So every fisherman spend as a seasonal, so time schedule. And at first, I requested the fishermen to teach to the students. My students, mostly, they have three variations. So one is just after the school, around 20 years old, and the middle is 40 years old. They want to change a career to be more fishing, or fisherman, or new life, for example. And the third one is after the retirement. For example, they want to have another more natural lifestyle. So the student mostly is this three generation. And but the middle of maybe two, three times we spend this program in 2 years, we suddenly so understand, so if we continue to this program, so we need more reaction from the students. And we change a little bit programs to we try to request to the student to propose to the fisherman's village some possibility or new program, for example. But he is working at the time, so he is working also United Nations, for example, in Japan. And he also had a familiar to be, because he working for the, for example, Africa or South Asia or many countries to support it to the kind of development. So this kind of experience also had, he had some knowledge of the idea to supporting. That's why so he participated this school and proposed them to have a kind of making a new framework for doing the exchangeable program. So, and also that we did cooking recipe development. Now it's very, now that everybody is very hungry, so I'm very sorry so far. But it looks very, yeah, it's very nice. For example, this is all materials coming from the area. For example, this is walnut with some fish, and also this is tomato and fish. I'm very hungry. And so fishing and mushroom, etc. It's very wonderful. So, but at first, the fishermen, they didn't have not so familiar to the European type of the taste, the cooking. But after this, they are very happy to understand, wow, it's the first time to eat pizza, fishing pizza, or something like that. So these kind of things, it makes them more encouraged to do something new. So. And also one of the problems of this area is For example, I think mostly the disaster area has the same problem. For example, the lower part, originally, so the area, all residents having the many kind of lower part were occupied by residential, so small building. But for example, this area, the tsunami has a 16 meter high. So that means all lower part were washed away. So the old house were gone, so by tsunami. So that means the area were very, very dangerous area for living. So. But this tsunami is every 1,000 year happens. So. So that is also the kind of a strong tsunami and very so not seldom, so the kind of very so special so tsunami, but the people cannot leave anymore that area. So that's why so people have to look some new place for living, so on the hill. So. And but on the hill, it's covered forest and the hill, there are no road to the area, so that's access, no access. So they need to make a flat land, and also they need to make access and as a new planning. So this kind of planning process, and also the making the structure or construction process, it also takes a time. So that this kind of a delay of the recovery or time of the recovery, it also makes them so very difficult to leave or back also. But because this beach had many lower parts, that's why so. In fact, if newcomer coming as a program of the fisherman school, so they couldn't find any places for living. So these projects remind us to the how. Okay, next step, so we need to make some land for newcomers. And then at first, we started to make a kind of finding the ancient mountain route to encourage as a tourist trip or tourist kind of route hiking, for example. And we tested several events for walking or hiking. And it's also the run with the ministry, national ministry, environmental ministry. And also that we in the once seventh fisherman school, so we discussing with also the local people and the students to think about how utilize the mountain sides. So, and we focus on the three position on the hill. And we made a model, so my students made a whole model, but all these kind of small layout is did the other this as a workshop. So that is also very interesting. So people also understand how you utilize a flat part in nature. So people can imagine that from the undulation of the land or geography of the land, the geography remind them to also the given the some sense of the camping or hiking or location. And one of these, we propose making the camping area as a newcomer area or testing the newcomer area. And this is the one of the seat after the working, after the workshop that my students made. And then now we started to testing the kind of the how utilize the mountain or how maintain the mountain with the collaboration with the volunteers and combining the fisherman school. So now the ocean and mountain, so very range of the activities are very so wide, but it's a very interesting program. So last winter we did. And in this program, so for example, we fishing, and also we cutting the tree. And after we dry the tree, and also milling, we ask to the milling, and also after that we design the furniture, and then in a workshop, we made a furniture by our own. So. And so this is also the each student made a different furniture. And yes. And now the, this program is will be realized as supporting for from the supporting was by one NPO. And this NPO was run by the very famous musician. They started to almost 10 years ago, so started to make create a kind of a natural kind of recovery or ecological activities NPO. And we asked them to support this program because existing forest were originally it was a field for the fishermen. So. And then we, when we visit the forest, we still have some sort of the stone wall in between and the stepping and like a terrace. And this proposal made by us and to create using the existing step as a kind of a cottage, main house and cottages and camping site. And now we started to construct time by time. So it's sometimes we ask the volunteer to join our project. And firstly, so the forest, this was a forest and very dark. We couldn't see the, any ocean. But after the cutting the tree, and we create a nice view to the ocean. And now the Bow Wow designed the main building. But it's small, unfortunately. So small, for example, 10 tatami room and the kitchen and the office and the toilet and the two bathroom, my big my communal bathroom. So it has a connected by transparent roof. And also behind, there is two cottages. And these, we expect two more cottages. The old cottages design, I asked the young generation architect to propose the as a DIY building. So the all timber coming from the, this forest, and also the we asked them to utilize as a whole material. And for example, they proposed me to the kind of tent atmosphere, the double double so story building along the slope, and also they proposed some making charcoal stove and the charcoal, for example, facade timber board for outside material, or but this is also the, another project by the two other architects. So the, we will have in this summer we will have some summer workshop or summer school, a similar framework of like Ostang what I show you the, in a Germany project. So so that it will be happen in this summer. So we need participants from maybe all over the world. So that if you are interested, please submit this program. And okay, so this is summarize all the idea. Now what now we are doing. But this is a kind of a summary of the whole things. But we, today I explained the resources. And the resources means the nature and the human, or also the skill, or many knowledges. And but in fact, the many of the things will have a kind of boundary. The boundary given sometimes institutional things or system of the society itself, or a lot of knowledge sometimes, so it gives them to have a wall. So, because 20th century, our society are very industrialized, and this industry, the given the society to make a kind of section, small section, and kind of special technology to enclose to for each specialized profession or etc. And but before maybe industrialization, so many people can do everything, for example. Not too high skill sometimes, but they can do, for example, they can make a house, they can make a clothes, they can make a cooking, or they can make a, yeah, everything so sometimes. But this industrial society give us a more kind of rich or quality of the life. But somehow, so we had some lack of the different level of the quality of the life. So then now, for example, why we are going to the rural area? So because the rural area has still keeping the some sort of the skill or knowledge of the living condition. And also, the for example, urban context, we can find also some interesting kind of knowledge, of course. But in this case, so we can learn a lot of things, this kind of ethnographical point of view. And we can bring this knowledge into some sort of the in between the industry society and my ethnographical, so a traditional local one. So I think mostly our proposal, so not back to the history, more than learning the history to come back, the kind of make a more connection. But this is also the one of the method of the 21st century in the future. So I hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much.
You made everyone hungry.
Everybody hungry.
Everybody hungry. Thank you, Momoyo, for this fantastic tour. It was really a journey.
Journey.
Because of course, I started my introduction reminiscing in a way of about your thinking and practice that was so incredibly embedded within the density of Tokyo and the hybridity of its conditions and. You know, finding inspiration and evidence, and then, of course, you're invited to practice elsewhere, and the question is, this obsession with Tokyo, how does it translate elsewhere? And in fact, it does translate. You find it, in the beautiful pier that you designed in Bruges. You know, this platform is going underneath the bridge, and sort of there's a kind of three dimensionality to it, even though it's quite flat. But the roof covers just one part of it, and then there is this kind of really nice touch with the flags, and there's a narrative, and a kind of. Highlighting the everyday transformation of the water through that kind of visual sign that's also architectural. There's also the little camp, the DIY camp, where you're drifting away from Tokyo, but nevertheless, your little greenhouse structure, is transforms, and there's a lot of intelligence in terms of its use and its flexibility, and it's a small space that can perform many things, and it's typological, and same thing with the little forest building that you called, where there's this kind of sectional quality, and But you also start to see that, in fact, your engagement, you know, sort of moving from the density of the city to the density of the forest, you know, you're starting to do your diagram, right? You're starting to find clues in the forest that comes back to inform the work in the city. That structure is made out of timber. There's a kind of renewed consciousness of resources, and so you're hybridizing the kind of multiple program and the use and the typology with the question of wood, and your section, your beautiful section of the village in Fukushima, you know, from the house to the forest, that becomes a section in your project in the city. So you're starting to do that. And I think that, and then there are these kinds of obsessions, right? Food and the forest and process and the network. And your fascination with these loops of productions and like taking us through the narrative of who's doing what work and where do the sweet potatoes come from and where do they get, so you know, as an architect, you're taking your architectural thinking and you're kind of thinking through all these processes and all these situations, and you're creating a physical environment for them and a campus, and which is the same as when we think about, it's the same as how you thought about Tokyo and the systems and the life within the structures and how the two are intertwined, and of course the last diagram clarifies everything, but somehow halfway through, I was thinking, you know, it is true, because actually. And it's when you started to talk about the fishermen that, you know, there are very many different kinds of fishermen, and it is amazing how our life has been reduced to so few choices. Like in the world with so many choices, hundreds of types of cereal, we have so few choices of the ways that we do things, the ways that we engage one another, and it's become a problem because. What are we going to do when the robots are going to take over? I mean, right? That's the, you know, the last, what's happening now in the world with this is you know, what are we going to do? What are the jobs of the future when artificial intelligence comes in? But also, you know, what do we do after shopping? Like, what is the city after shopping? I mean, Amazon is taking care of shopping. So what do we do? And it does seem that you're kind of finding in the rural these, you're expanding again. Like, no, you can fish this way or that way or this way, and then you can. So it's not about the potatoes. It's about re-expanding. Right, the everyday life and what we could do, and we had a conversation. Before we, you know, earlier this afternoon, and you were saying, you know, for the first time you have people who are 80 and people who are, you know, 3 or 5, you know, is there an exchange there that is a form of work or a form of pleasure or a form of education or a form of, so I was, of course, also thinking about, when you had your participatory DIY, I was thinking about Arcosanti and Soleri and, you know, building your own kind of utopia. But I was then thinking about, of course, there is a long legacy which you're really part of, when the metabolists were not only thinking about the city, they were thinking about, I mean, Kikutake's Ocean City had the fish farm, and even though it was dense, food was integrated, or Kurokawa's agricultural city. And so anyway, I mean, this is kind of what, you know, I think as the lecture unfolded, it really became clear how there's a richness, in the same way that you brought a richness of your analysis of Tokyo and the urban density. It's almost like the urban density was where we thought the culture of congestion exists, but now it's become so homogeneous that we have to rediscover heterogeneity and diversity and density somewhere else. I don't know if you wanted to, like, I mean, it kind of made sense. What are the jobs of the future in cities, or or how do you see further that thinking now informing how we organize ourselves in cities? Or
I don't know exactly. I still continue to the working with the fishermen. But for example, now 88 years old, a very cool guy. I like a lot. So because of the, yeah, he's cool, very. Yeah? For example, and I can learn, for example, when he cut the fish, so it's really sliced, very carefully and very nice. And the best sashimi I think what I ever had, for example. So something like so. But he is not running the restaurant. Yeah? Just he's fun for his life. So we can learn from him. So, for example, in the forest industry. So, for example, we taking out of the skin of the, for example, cedar tree by hand. But also sometimes we cut the tree. I have a backache, so I don't do it. But I ask to the student or with participant also to do so to bring.
So when them. You take Momoyo studio, be ready to.
But bring up to the so together. So 1, 2, 3, bam, something like so. But it's a high kind of so it's a very nice experience. People can learn by very so physical, tactical, naka kind of how can I say physical. Thank you very much. Physical sense of the hand. And for example, I like also the doing, for example, researches in, for example, made in Tokyo. We walk many, many days. That time, so I was a student and I'm very, have a lot of time so to walk around. Maybe so I spend almost 2-3 weeks or riding the bicycle or walking or driving, so different method. And it's like a kind of summer vacation in a childhood. So looking for like some special insects or something like that. So that it's almost hunting. So in this kind of very cool physical research is also help us understanding. So. And when we go to the mountain, I see also a lot of the difference now. For example, this tree is planted by which period, for example, or which kind of tree we are planting. And also if we walk several times, for example, a fisherman's village in new residence area, mostly so it was expected by the hilly area that we have to walk around sort of which place is good or best or something like that. And this kind of several experience brings us to some knowledge in some brain or also physical condition. So I think, of course, computer is also very good to kind of gather, connecting by the kind of information. Of course, this is also very important. So I email and also I doing the Skype, but it's also very important to meet directly or feeling the physical life and et cetera. And also, for example, now the 90 or 80 years old guy, they didn't use the computer. Yeah? That's why, so if we may try to meet them, we need without computer to discuss with them and just to jump in their world and the talk started to. And so that is also kind of, I feel, the kind of the last moment so we can reach them. Because, for example, in Japanese case also, they're around 60 years old, but they are also the more 70, also the 70 years old. That means already so after World War II, baby boomer generation, they already a little bit change as a culture or my physical sense, I think. But I think if you have some chance to meet 80 years old, 90 years, 100 years old.
So it's history, right? I mean,
yes,
to kind
yes.
of really record that oral history. And it reminds me also, we had a show last year here in collaboration with the Canadian Center for Architecture called The Other Architect, that, you know, moment which really starts in the 60s of, you know, these architects who really start to engage with participatory design and community engagement, but also get into process, right? So it's not so much the obsession with the object, but almost the obsession with the process, and you end with this kind of designing of relationships and of processes. And so it is a moment where you're in now, and you know, do you miss the object at times, or is that your object at this time? And and you know, is the book a way to kind of, or a representation of these processes, a way to kind of render it more tangible?
So I think that about afternoon, so we are discussing, so what it is to the form, or how, for example, we use the word or the behaviorology. For example, every, for example, building or some physical element could be related to the nature, or related to the people, or related to the history transformation. And in that means, Bow Wow is always trying to find the meaning, but the meaning is always the coming of the relationship between something. And then, so we try to grasp this, what is the meaning of the things, or what is the effect of the things? And if we can start to imagine every form or every element or every materiality could be effect in history, I don't know, 100 years ago, or today, or future. So we can design more, I think, rich quality of the using. So. And then, imagination is also very important for design for us. Because, for example, what is related to the fisherman's story? Sorry, back to the fisherman's story. But, for example, fishermen, they don't see in the sea, in the ocean, in the water. But they imagine totally the fisherman's activity or landscape in a context on the boat, from the boat. So that is very interesting. So something like similar. So that's why, so when I spoke with this 80 years old fisherman, so he understood what I tried to say always. So I think he's also very clever captain, very so knowledgeable also captain, but I think I feel so he can imagine so many things. And I want to be also the train, so to be more many different kind of things. I think I need more experience. That's why, so if I start to, for example, talk to the fishermen, for example, of course they are at first very so different society and different type of people, but he explained several times, or now I also started to imagine in the water, for example. So that is also very interesting. So.
But it makes sense, actually, that you're obsessed with the fishermen, because for me, it's your buildings, you know, when you did pet architecture and the way you drew them, you know, the buildings, you talked about the face, they became character in your story. And now, you know, these characters happen to be buildings, but now these new characters happen to be human, and or, you know, so I think it you know, it is still kind of very continuous. And I wanted to, I was curious about, you know, this is something that came up with the conversation with Li Hu last week, about almost the architects need to kind of design their client also. I mean, it's amazing to me that you started with so many houses and, you know, and then, but rather than, you know, the typical trajectory, certainly here, you know, would be like you start with the house and you end with luxury condos. And, you know, you guys started with the house and you were ending with NGOs and kind of, you know, government work and you know, community work. And I mean, you're also kind of, you've launched a process that is snowballing and getting you, it seems, you know, you're also designing a process by which you're invoking the clients that you want. Or was that something that was intentional? Or
It's also always the client gave us more kind of new experiment or new experiences too. So, and for some rich client, or some, they are, if they have some profession, so different professions, so they gave us so new kind of idea or lifestyle, and also different contexts give us also kind of notice or knowledge of the life. So, yeah, that is also very, very interesting. So for, and also the, when we designed several houses, but now almost 50, 60, so the individuals from a big size, different area. But for example, now that we had many projects coming from the client, for example, now, but there is also the kind of general social aspect in the commission, for example. But of course, the age of us, or what most of the mostly is, I think now that, for example, many clients want to have a renovation of the old their parents' house. So because mostly the house were located in a rural area, and and then they already moved to the urban, so some Tokyo or some Osaka, some area, but they need to take care of their parents' house, for example. And that means their parents are maybe so 80, 90, or sometimes already they are dying. So the abandoned house or vacant house will be vacant, so in a sense, that they need to think about the reuse or demolish or changing the kind of house as a their lifestyle. So that's why, this is also the today's individual houses issues in Japan. So that is also very interesting. My kind of research. In some moment, why we started to that, for example, townhouse issue, machia issue. But that time, so we had a really little, mostly the land were very small and then narrow and long. The many houses coming in some certain 5 years or so. Then we started to think about how we create this framework of the individual houses commitment. And to into the framework of the design, so something like so. And then now that I think the next step maybe so we are thinking the reform or transformation of the existing structure. So this is also the kind of the research. And then now that we last week so we break down the existing old structure, that's farmhouse. It was around 100 years ago, it was built. And we break down at first, but we utilize as a main structure, so for the future house. So, but in that case, for example, the carpentry group, the construction company, so they said that during the process, former, they had many this kind of project, but recent, they didn't have not so much this kind of project. That means
they lost all the chance of the using the technology. Mm-hmm. But we started to propose as a architectural building or architectural work this kind of using the existing structure to using the new frame. So maybe I don't know, some other architects or some other people are very interested in starting to the using the also the existing structure. That's it also kind of new idea for making the building. So
yeah, so as Jorge Otero Palos, who directs the preservation program here, you know, preservation is certainly probably one of the most exciting kind of experimental space right now for architecture.
Yeah.
So it's really interesting to hear you engage it as well. And it's also interesting for me that the, I mentioned it also in my introduction and it came up, you know, a little bit today in conversation, and I'm wondering whether it bothers you, but this kind of abandonment of large bigness, right, is kind of like exhaustion that I think many of our generation have felt, this kind of wanting to get back to a scale where certain narratives, human narratives, kind of make sense. Mm. And I guess the only question then would be, is the impact enough? Or how do you measure impact? Or, right, in terms of, the impact of the small, let's say, whether it can add up or...
Smaller project or small scale, you mean?
Small scale, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Or whether that's even important. Maybe it's not important, right? Maybe it's also the ideas that come out of it.
Small scale is very, difficult to design, in fact, I think. We need the detail and we need the strategy or also the kind of scale controlled by thinking. And that retrained a small site, for example, and urban context. In New York, maybe, so you need also a lot of the technology or kind of manner of the making building. So this urban context also makes us more kind of a lot of knowledge for developing. So, and then with this kind of knowledge, back to some rural area or this small scale could be also used this knowledge to the large scale. So I think that is also one of the things. But what is the difficult, sometimes a big project needs more people. And in that sense, we sometimes collaborate with a large design architects group, for example. So we also open to the collaboration. Mm-hmm. And if we have some foreign project or overseas project, we also working with a local architect together. Mm-hmm. So this is also very fun for get exchange of knowledge.
Right. Mm. I should open it up if any of you have questions.
I'll speak up.
Good.
First of all, thank you. It was very beautiful to hear. In the 1K project about the attention to the workforce, which you also are getting into here with the big offices, and the distribution of the work, who gets to do what, the community aspects. And I would like if you are able to talk a little bit about how the internal work is in your office, which... Is it just architects employed, and what is the relationship between the people you employ and yourself?
Building. So last part I couldn't hear. Building.
How is your office designed in terms of the kind of workforce?
Workforce in our office. Mm-hmm. Our office is very not so big office. Né? Just to run two other partner, now the Yoshiharu and also another
younger architect, but he has many career with us. So the Yoichi Tamai, we are three partners. And also we have another 8 architects, and also my parents is counting. And as a kind of practice for, yeah? And also Yoshi have a laboratory in Tokyo Tech, and he has maybe in a laboratory around 30 students from the bachelor to doctor, and also the researcher. And I have run the laboratory in the University of Tsukuba. I have a student, maybe 10 around. And but today I didn't show, but so we are working the really so parallel, so studying in or teaching in university. And in Japanese case, the laboratory system is very different from US frame. So US has many semester unit and divided to the more time to the talk with the different the professor or talk to the different tutor. But for example, in Japanese case, for example, master thesis, they write one laboratory. So, and some of the bachelor students that study to the bachelor thesis, in my laboratory. So that means that they spend at least, for example, until master, so they spend 3 years in my laboratory. So that is really like a, not children, but a kind of, so it's a really long span dialogue. Very so discuss I and also student, and also some of them, they are going to the doctor course. So in that sense, I think almost they spent 8 or 10 years in our laboratory. So it's, I think it's more kind of very deep and collaborative, but influenced each other. So that I, for example, today I didn't show any project about the hospital. But I also working a lot of the hospital design issue in my university. But it's also the influenced from the my student doctor thesis. So I collaborate with her a lot of things. So, and also the this kind of things. I was also influenced by the student a lot. But also I influenced them to also a lot, maybe. So Yoshi has also many doctor students, and also they have also the nice, some so special aspect or special theme from each. And these kind of things makes us also very interesting collaboration. Nothing.
Oh.
Hi. Hi.
Thank you for the talk. Hi, thank you. You mentioned at one point, I think during the Shrine project, that perhaps there's a connection between the kind of dilapidation of the forest and there's other distractions now in our contemporary society, including technology. So I was curious to, considering this hybrid between 20th and 21st century, how do you factor in the media technologies that we have, like smartphones and internet?
Yeah, for example, the traditional scale of the timber structure is very kind of limited of the length or the beam length or the height or et cetera. And also the fire code or fire protection code, it's also sometimes very difficult to realize in the urban context. But now some of the new material coming, and also the scale of the beams, for example, sometimes the laminate timber that could be make a larger scale for making a larger building. So in that sense, the building originally scale was just made in concrete or steel, but now that we can make with timber or other materials. So. And then one of the good things that timber is we can use also the as a surface of the surface of the, for example, furniture, or more warm and very kind of so very warm surface and nice looking, etc. And also, I think mostly Japanese building sometimes we take off the shoes in a house, né? So that kind of touching on the surface in interior. So it's also for Japanese interior kind of. That sense of the interior is also very important to keep in such a large scale with the timber. So that and also timber it makes us also very good for the lot of the in Japan we had many humid in summertime, so the or rainy season, so it affect also the good kind of some sense of the control of the humidity. So, and also we had a very natural forest or good forest for the making things. So the, now the government, of course, supported many subsidizing. So for the created a new innovation of the timber. But also the, it's also, it's very so fun for thinking so to the possibility. And, I think maybe we are not only just the technology issue. We try to combine the kind of interior space and the structure and the facade, how continuous to thinking that relate to the each other. So that sense, I think timber is one of the interesting material now, so for us too. So, but of course, steel and. I like steel and concrete too, so my house is steel and concrete, so but it depends, so.
Okay. I think we're gonna thank Momoyo for a fantastic lecture. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.